According to the National Cancer Institute, approximately 40% of the people in the US are diagnosed or will be diagnosed with cancer sometime in their life. Image one shows us. With this in mind, let's ask ourselves one question. Why the treatment of cancer is still so difficult? One reason is that the first image that shows the evidence of cancer in our body is obtained at very late stages. Why is that? Let's take a look at the available imaging options we have. Picture two. We have X-ray and CT, which are dangerous, which are painful, and they can easily destroy the molecules of body. And we have MRI, which is safe, but it is so expensive that even if the patient survives the cancer, the medical bills are gonna kill him. That's why doctors cannot send us easily to imaging labs to check our body. So what's the alternative for these current dangerous and expensive methods? Here is where my research comes in. Microwave imaging. Microwave imaging uses low frequency and low power devices. That's why it is cheap and it is safe. And they can be used as a cancer screening tool like blood pressure monitor. Now, let me take you through the process of microwave imaging and explain how it works. Picture three shows a part of human body which consists of normal cells and tumors. But doctors wouldn't know this from a regular checkup. And we are going to see what is gonna be inside of that, which is imaging. Here is our approach. We assume that the body is made of multiple layers. We take one layer. Each layer is made of many cells, and each cell has a specific material with a unique number known as permittivity. And we are going to find those numbers for that layer. It is like a code, and we are going to crack that code. How? We send safe electromagnetic waves from one side of the body and collect the information from the other side of the body. And then, based on the algorithm that I have written, I can find those numbers. Let's say here we have 222999 for that layer. The next step is to map each number to a specific color. Let's say here we map 2 to a light color and 9 to a dark color. So the imaging for one slice is done. The next step is to go and repeat the process for other slices. And then we connect them all together. It is like a puzzle, and we are going to complete that puzzle slice by slice. As you can tell from the last image at the bottom left, the final image of the body is created, and we can distinguish between the normal cells and tumors. Ultimately, microwave imaging can provide us with a safe, cheap, and effective method. And we are thinking of a day when these devices can be used as easily as blood pressure monitors to screen our body to see if there is a cancer or not. Hopefully not. Thank you.